We are honoring a dear friend who is a towering force in movie history. In addition to being a great artist, he's also a fellow countryman, Federico Fellini. Federico Fellini, in appreciation of one of the screen's master storytellers. Congratulations. Yeah. Can I give you a kiss?
Yes, I want.
Not a man.
Thank you.
Well, I really did not expect it. Or perhaps I did, but not, but wait, but not before another 25 years. Anyway, it's better now. I want to thank all of you. In these circumstances, it's easy to be generous and to thank everybody. I cannot nominate everyone. Let me make only one name of an actress who is also my wife. Thank you, dearest Giulietta, and please stop crying.
Famous director, probably the most famous filmmaker of the time.
Fellini represents this paragon of creativity and fantasy.
His films are all about himself. It's what he knew best. He is considered a superstar.
Became a trademark name like Ford or Sony. The name suggested that feeling you got, that style from Fellini movies, which is the sacred and the profane. The humorous, the larger than life, the poetic, the funny, all of that wrapped into one Fellini-esque.
And after all, he's just made the most successful film in European film history in terms of box office. Now what does he do? I mean, how do you follow that?
Of all of his films, 8½ is the one that's the most magical. Because there is this kind of interweave of dream, fantasy, and reality.
Fellini is one of the greatest artists, not only in filmmaking, one of the greatest artists of the 20th century. He's the most Italian among the Italian filmmakers, and at the same time, the most universal.
I hope the people who see this see the Fellini films, because they will tell you more about him than anybody can tell you about him. See his movies, that's Federico Fellini.